And now, moving forward, ladies and gentlemen, our third speaker session for today. The topic is going to be building brands by connecting people to their passion. This session is conducted by Mr. Shubhodip Pal. Shubhodip Pal comes with over 19 years of consumer marketing experience in launching, building and managing brands from consumer durables to the banking, financial, IT hardware sector and telecom service sector. He has worked on the whole spectrum of marketing, specializing in product management, retail, marketing communications, media, sports, and entertainment marketing, online and mobile marketing. Ladies and gentlemen, may I request Mr. Pal to please come and join me on stage, and I request you all to kindly please welcome him with a big round of applause.
Thank you. Thank you for the introduction. I didn't know I did so many things. Good evening, guys. Are you guys awake? I think Sylvia had a brilliant presentation, and I think the work even before that, Nescafe did some brilliant work. I love the campaign myself personally. So now it's my time to tom-tom about the brand I represent. It's been like 21 years, actually. We've been in this marketing fraternity, and all of us have our own goals to accomplish, our own ambitions. But hey, after spending 11 years, 4 months, and 70 days with Samsung, 5 years with HP, 2 years with ABN AMRO, my last 6 years in Micromax has been a mayhem. In between, I did make movies as well with Balaji Motion Pictures. I put about 7 movies on the floor, the last one being Vera the Wedding. Did you guys like that movie? Yeah, again, a very, very different kind of movie. Something which connected with emotions, which Sylvia was talking about in the past. But again, it's the new age kind of an audience. So again, Ekta Kapoor, no matter what you say, knows exactly what drives passion here in India. And that's one great example of an industry which has actually evolved in front of us, be it the broadcast, be it the film industry. Similarly, brands have undergone this. Coming back to our story, we're not that old. We launched a brand in 2010. And in fact, we were a brand where people said, forget it, shut shop, go home. We had the Nokias at 92% market share. We had Samsung at almost gaining share, close to Nokia, and so on and so forth. We had HTC, we had BlackBerry. You name it all. I mean, there were brands, if I ask you today, don't exist, except for Nokia's trying to make a comeback right now. But believe you me, they won't last long. Sorry, I'm being a bit blunt over here, but yes, I can put up my call over here and talk about it, because we have done some great stuff over here. And some of the Indian brands who normally were challenger brands in the past are brands to reckon with right now. And that's simply because we've understood the needs of the country. We've understood the pulse which is required. We've innovated continuously to figure out what we need. And this slide will actually tell you exactly what we do. So when it comes to our GT kind of business, which is, sorry for the jargon, general trade, it's Micromax as a product. When it comes to the online trade, it's U Mobiles. What is technology in U Mobiles becomes a feature in Micromax 2 months down the line, because the product life cycle is not that long. So this is how we straddle both the brands in India. It's a classic example of, in today's world, Adidas and Reebok, Toyota and Lexus. I mean, they're very successful brands created. And again, each brand can generate or can build that curiosity of what each one can stand for, as long as you have certain rules and mantras which you need to follow, which I will slightly elaborate on as in, when I go along my slides. Just a quick one of Micromax at a glance. We are not just a mobile phone company. We make LEDs, we make ACs, we're launching our washing machines, we have tablets. We also have an installed base in this country, which is 41 million plus. If somebody understands the word installed base, which I'm sure all of you do, it's how do I generate revenues from that installed base, because they're already my consumers today. How can I generate more vast revenues? Again, we are more successful than telecom operators who have humongous bases of 100 million plus or 200 million plus, depending on which the telecom operator is. But again, they are not contextual enough to generate revenues. We have an ad agent system and a platform where we not only look at our own consumers, but we invite other brands themselves and use us as a publisher to push out, because we know exactly what you're doing and when. And it's not intentional. These people have opted in for our service, which basically means Sylvia has said, yes, I want advertising. I want in lieu of something in return, which I return to them, right? So it could be SMS bundle packs. It could be data packs. It could be movie tickets. It could be anything under the sun. And again, we start profiling the consumer based on the brand's need. We start servicing them. And it's almost like 100 crore plus revenue for me, which I also control. So therefore, the confusing designation I have, which is the most confusing one, I have expense on one side, which is the marketing aspect of it, and have revenue on the other side, is where I'm supposed to get money back into the company. So we've done about close to about 108 odd crores last year, which is not a small amount, and it's just purely hardcore hitting the bottom line. Some of the key milestones for us, which you need to see over here, simply because in 2012 when I joined them, we were just a $200 million company. But once we reached 2017, we are close to about a $2.2 billion company. It's all because of simply the way we innovate our products and we have our pillars defined. It's very easy to say that, yes, we understand consumer passion, but you will see very specific examples as to when I say MMS. It's music, movies, sports, but again, it's not all movies, it's not all sports, it's not all music per se. It has to be structured, it has to be segmented, it has to be delivered to the consumers where they are. If they say if Micromax is a tier one or tier two brand, I actually beat that journalist up in my head first and then try to explain to him or her as to what the hell are you talking about. It's very simple. We all live here in Delhi, right? If I have a consumer, if I'm trying to target a consumer, say in GK2, say through a print ad, you're trying to tell me that that same newspaper will not go to Kanpur, which is 5 kilometers away, you must be kidding yourself. So as far as we are concerned, we're very clear in terms of who are we addressing, how do we need to address, and we simply believe in what we stand for. We believe in democratization of technology, which basically means we do not make cheap products. We make products which are affordable. If you guys understand the difference, you've got your head clear and that's very easy to market. That holds for almost every brand sitting in this room today. It's just the way you segment the market and figure out what to do. Again, movies, that's our passion, right? Sports, which Sylvia spoke about, again, our passion. Music, we can't live without music, all of us know it. But do you know exactly what kind of music your consumers would love? Do you know exactly what kind of movies they would consume? Do you know exactly what kind of movies or sports would they watch or get affinity to? So these are little factors which you need to figure out. And once you've segmented the market and you've got the products for those markets, then life becomes even more simpler. It's not simply IPL, chalo paisa dal do, aage badho. That's all bullshit. Yes, it's a great platform to launch a product. It's a great, you know, experience for the next 60 games or 60 odd days to figure out what's going to happen next. However, if you don't have your product right, you're not there. If you don't have your communication right, say goodbye to your market share. It's as simple as that. My competition did a brilliant job this IPL. I think they did a damn good job. It spoke directly to the numbers, so it's a damn good job. So I think they got the strategy right for the first time after 3 years. But don't worry, we won't let them catch up much. So just to give an example of what happens going forward. Again, when you innovate, you have to do what's here. Again, it sounds like our resume, but please bear with me because these are things which people don't understand. Longest battery phones, the first, you have the Samsungs, you have the Nokias, you have the HTCs, you have the Blackberries of the world. They couldn't even innovate one of any of the lists which I've put over here. We're the first ones in the world to come out with a dual SIM phone. When I talk about a dual SIM phone in a Russia where we are also present, where people are actually flabbergasted by the fact that they think we're creating magic. We're not. We just understood the product need in India and created a dual SIM phone simply because all of us were used to different tariff plans from different operators. And every time people were actually swapping SIM cards. And that's when we recognized the fact that, hey, there is an opportunity to actually create a dual SIM phone simply with electricity, which is of scarcity across the country, except for our towns where we think we live in castles, but we actually go down to the tier two, the tier three, the tier four markets, people actually walk 50 kilometers, 40 kilometers, walk, take a bus, take a ride, drive, use a cycle, do whatever, just to charge their phones for 15 bucks. So why can't we create a phone which has a long battery life? So these are like simple examples of how one should look at the market, not just by creating things just for the heck of it, but understanding consumer needs and taking things forward. Again, I'm saying let's go beyond the traditional ways of marketing. We created a havoc in India when we got Hugh Jackman in. And again, Hugh Jackman is not meant for my target consumer. Hugh Jackman was meant for the guys who actually used the perishable product, also called as Apple, okay? Because they are the ones who suddenly took one by saying, hey, what the hell is Micromax doing? Again, Mr. Wolverine cut across the person living in JK1 to Kanpur, to Badshahpur, to any other pur, right? Because he was such a popular icon that he actually transcended and helped the brand elevate to another level. And if I was going to markets like Russia and parts of Eastern Europe and now the Africas, this gentleman cuts across all those markets again. So the simple bottom line mantra for us was very simple. How can I create relevant contextual communication which can work for me across the globe no matter where my consumer is? Because if I concentrate on these three pillars, which everybody thinks is easy, but trust me, it's not, you have most of your success done. Again, if your creative is right, and again, cuts across borders, you've done through. And I think Nescafe is doing a brilliant job there. It's simple communication. They've Indianized it, but I love the gold one as well. It's a way of connecting with people, and like Sylvie also said, emotions. If you've got an emotive connect going, then things are on another different platform. Stuff around social cause. I mean, when we launched the fingerprint, and we launched a very simple thing, we got Kapil Sharma on board, and we actually said, Angrezi panti ko dikhao ungli. And we actually got an award here in this forum last year. And this is another example of how to contextualize your communication with technology and therefore making it more accessible to people. Topical days. Everybody does stuff around Mother's Day, Father's Day, this one's day, Valentine's Day. But again, you've got to have relevant communication around it. Our Mother's Day campaign, if you look at the numbers over here, 15 million impressions, 6.5 million views, was very simple. It's a very simple idea which we took. Whenever you get a call from your mother, if you're busy in a meeting, or even if you're not so busy, haan mummy, baad mein phone karta hun. I'll call you later. That's the thing. But again, we connected that Indian insight with how phones can be leveraged and then things taken forward. Micromax Cup was another example. We did the Father's Day campaign. And again, I think the beauty of again using our phone was the Unite 2 anthem. This was the first time we launched a phone last year with 21 different languages. We actually used 9 different singers from different parts of this country, from a Benny Dayal to a Neeti to anybody you name, to actually create one anthem which translates across the country. It's more on the lines of Mere Sul Hamara, if you heard that campaign, right? It's one of the best, most successful campaigns we had a couple of decades back. But again, it's a reiteration of that, and we actually were successful in those numbers. And all these actually translate to market share. It's just not just for the heck of it. Every number, unfortunately for us, IDC, Counterpoint, Cyber Media, they're after our lives. Someone talks about retail share, someone talks about shipments. But for us, cumulatively, what's important is to also drive numbers. Any guesses of how many phones we do in a month? Just a wild guess? Three what? Very close. 3.4 million phones a month. Bhaiya, 34 lakh phone koi bech ke dikhao. It's a very, very different thing altogether. 34 lakh phones, if I were to convert it to 3.4 million, it's humongous. I have friends from Intex here as well. They know the challenge. It's not that easy. Inventory levels of 500,000 in a warehouse, if you go to any other brand, they will sweat. For us, that's the minimum inventory we need to keep. Okay? So this is some examples of Vue, which is slightly a more younger kind of a brand, talking to a slightly more upscale kind of a audience. But again, everything's related and it's relegated only to the online presence. So again, building brands but figuring out what the consumer's passions are sounds very good. Do you know what those passions are? Do you know when those products can connect with those passions? Those are critical factors which actually figure out. And finally, timing of the event and the launch is very sacrosanct to your market shares. And that's, I think, one of the critical points we have in our business. Unlike the durable business, which has seasonality, the mobile business, you change your phone almost every 8 to 9 months. That's the average today. People carry almost 1.8 phones in this country, which is almost 2 phones in this country. So again, no matter what you do in your life, it's not even 6 inches away from you. So that's the beauty of this business. And again, if you understand what is India, if you understand what's Bharat, you've understood your game plan of actually reaching out to consumers. If that 250 million people are important to you, then India is your market. If you want the balanced 1 billion people, then Bharat's your market. And if you can find a story between the two, which is not tough, you've got your home and dry as far as your brand's concerned. Some of the other brands, sorry Sylvia, but Nike is one brand I really like because I think they've been very consistent in terms of what they do and the storytelling techniques they have. Coca-Cola is another brand who built passions in India. Like Coke Studio was brilliant in Pakistan, but they understood music as a pulse in this country. And they actually built the entire strategy around it. It's been on for the last, I think, for the last almost 7-8 years now. I think they've done some brilliant jobs, some great talent. They do American Idol in the US, so it's another different thing altogether. Netflix, they've adapted us so quickly in this country, it's unbelievable. Like Sacred Games and the rest of Mossad and all these things coming up is actually picking up what we love in movies into simple Netflix originals, which have 7, 8, 10 episodes, which normally we binge on the weekends or before, and then figure out what's next. And finally, Tesla. The way they've innovated in the car industry, they've understood what the consumer passions are. They know exactly what they want, and that's how they start moving up, right? Finally, before I start, I'm going to just show you a couple of examples of the kind of communication we do. When we mean democratization of technology, we actually mean it, and that's how we're going to live. So a couple of commercials, and then one little AV to actually sum up what I've talked about, music, movies, and sports, and then I'll have my final slide. Thank you for bearing with me. Again, it's just, if you've actually gone through the list, it's not everything. It's not everything. Because we've handpicked, cherry-picked exactly where we want to be, and we actually dovetailed our creatives to talk to this audience. It's not any kind of movie. It's not any kind of sport. Very specific genres of music, and so on and so forth. So what you really need to do and understand as a marketer and encourage your partners and your agencies is to actually figure out if they've understood it. I'm pretty engrossed in music, movie, sports, so I can pick and choose. But in today's day and age, it's changing rapidly because the consumers today are consuming content in a very different way. Finally, this is one slide which I have. Sorry, if you go back. You need to celebrate you. That's the most important key part of this. We need to cater to the taste buds of almost 1.3 billion people. Consistency in creatives is one thing which I really urge everybody to look at. One size does not fit all, we all know it, but do we really adapt to it is something you guys really need to think about. If all of the above is fine, social media, which we actually don't use so much, is actually gasoline because you already have a lot of fire out there. If you actually have a nice ORM team and if you have the right social strategy, then obviously that works wonders. And finally, for me, marketing is just about flirting. If you know your TG, if you understand what their needs are, if the creative has broken through, half your job is done and the rest is history. Thank you very much and being so patient, audience.